Hello everyone, I'm Rajesh from ACN Technology. We are learning complete PHP course from beginner to professional level. And last class we learned variables, right? And this class we are going to learn data type. So you guys already know some data types like integer, string and float, right? But today we are again going to review. So first is integer. So you guys know integer means, right? I'm just going to make variable and here some number. So this is integer. Why? Because you don't have point, right? Yeah, so this is integer. Let me print this number, print echo, and I'm going to write num. I'm not going to here make bracket. If you don't write bracket, is also fine. If you write bracket, is also fine. So I'm not going to write here bracket. So number is 200, right? So let me here, and here localhost and php enter, you see 200. So this is integer or float? So this is integer, of course, because you don't have point, right? So what about second one? I'm going to write here second. Now float means num 1. Float means same, right? 300, but there have point. Same like integer, but integer don't have point, here have point. So let me print echo, let me print num1, don't forget semicolon, you see here, right? Here have point, that means this is float. And what about others? Let me delete this one also. So again, next one is, after this we already know string, right? String you guys already know. For example, my name, double quote, right? String always between double quote. So I'm going to write here Rajesh Kumar Yadav, and don't forget here semicolon. So let me print here echo name, correct? So you, that is Kumar Yadav, right? Very nice, right? So you guys already know these three: integer, float and string. So today we are going to learn something new here. So what is new? Nothing much, but little bit. For example, first one is boolean. This is very important in PHP or anywhere. Boolean in nothing, just there have two condition, true or false. True or false. This one always using when we use if else statement. So here is bit difficult to give you example, but I can try to give you some bit example. For example, let me make one variable a is true, and one variable c is false. So this two is what? Boolean. So I cannot print this two. If you want, you can print, but this is not perfect to print, because this is just expression, means true or false is expression, not a type, not a date, not a number, not a string. So you no need to print this two. So you just have to know boolean means true or false. When we use if else, then I will tell you again what is true and false, what is boolean, right? And what about next? Next is array and object. Array is nothing, and array is very nice and very useful in your program. When we will use like a big data, and thus all data is same data, right? For example, here is integer, just have one. What about if I have a five integer? So I have to write five times, right? This one. But when, if you use array, so you have to line just one single line, and you can print the all variables which one you want. So here int array means always use for same type of data. Means if there have same type of data, so you can use array. If I have one or more than two and the same type of data, like integer or same type of float or same type of string, then you can use array. Let me give you one example here. For example, I have my one array. The array name is country, right? So all country is always the same, right, in float, right? Country is not going to write in integer, not going to write in float. So integer always going to write in string, right? Not float, what I'm telling you. So here, just create here new array and code this bracket. If you don't want to use bracket, it's also fine, but use here bracket and the name, and see always inside string, right? Because country is always string, so always inside here, maybe Nepal, and here separate with comma, and the second one maybe India, separate with comma, third one maybe China, separate with comma, fourth one Africa, separate with comma, fifth one maybe America AM, and they separate with comma, right? So you see all is string, right? So if you have a too many same kind of data, you see same kind of all is string, or if you have a same integer, then you can use array. If you use array, that means you no need to create the same things five times, create in single line. If you don't use array, you have to write the same things is as a five times. For example, you can have to create like this: country is equals to Nepal. Then again, you have to create country maybe one is equals to India. So this is not a proper, right? It's very big and too much line. That's why using array. So I will give a very nice example when we do project using PHP MySQL. That time you understand very well. This time also you can understand very well. If you have the same kind of data, same. If it's string, 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 then use in single line. If you have same, like country, name, your office name, your office workers. So you can use array and the name between double quote. Very easy, right? If I want to print the country, means I want to print the all from here. So you cannot print like a same, you cannot print using like just echo. It's a bit different. So different what? Bar underscore dump. And after dump, you have to write bracket here and the your variable name. So my variable name is country. So I'm going to write here. And here semicolon. Let me run. You will see two big here. So you see here total have five array. That means here inside have five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? And the first one means index first. The first index. There have string five, means five letters, five characters. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? You see here. And the five and the name is Nepal. Understand, right? And also it is going to tell you string. You see here string, the name is string and they have five letter, same like this first one. And array always start from 0, so this one is 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4, the same, right? So this is array, how you create array in our PHP program. So let me learn next one. If you guys don't understand this one, it is not a matter. I will teach you again and again in next class, and you can see the video again and again, and you will understand very well. So let me create a new one. So I'm going to delete this all from here, and then now I'm going to teach you object, how to create object in PHP. So object is not like a core PHP. This object same like OPHP, not like OPHP, is OPHP, object-oriented programming. So this one is bit different with others, but you guys understand very well. If you guys don't understand this last one, you no need to worry, because object is not a core PHP. Object is or PHP, but I can teach you. So here I'm going to make one object, right? If you want to make object, you always need class, and the class any name, which name you want. I just want country, right? So I'm going to make class. So don't write this one, always you make mistake. Just this sign, and inside here I want to make too many function. So what is function? You don't need to worry now, I will teach you later. So this is one class, and this side in class name is country, and inside country have too many functions. I will call this class one time and I can print many times. So let me create a new function here, one more function, and maybe function language, alien language. So function always use bracket, right? So here, so this is class and this is function, and inside function I want one name, any name you need. So you have to write this, and whatever you want. Maybe I want nep, means nep means Nepal, right? So Nepal is just to have a Nepali language. Understand? This one is one class, main class, and in this class I have one function. The function name is long, means language, and let me write the whole name here. It's easy to understand. Country. So now you see this one is name, and this one is class. The country, and this one is function country, and this side function country have one and nep means Nepal, right? And here have the country name, full name Nepal. So here you see, from here to here I'm going down here, and I want to make here one object now. So now if you want to make one object, just write anything what you want. I'm going to write Nepal, and it's equal to new, and this function name. Understand, right? This function name, just copy from here and paste here. That means now this Nepal have this all things from copy from here to here now. So if I want to print this Nepal, then that means I want to print the all from here. So let me print here. So it's very easy, just echo and they write Nepal, and this sign means I'm going to print Nepal from where, and which I'm going to print. I'm going to print what? Here I have too many things, right? NP. So I just want to print NP. And if I want to print, I just semicolon here. Let me run Nepal. How? Let me show you again. I made one class, and inside class I made one function, and inside function I want this nep. Means this name means this name is name is string. I think you guys are confused, right? If you guys are confused, you no need to worry, because this is we are not going to use in our project, in now project. This is where we will use when we learn framework. So this is op concept, that's why I'm laughing. No problem. So this is name and nep, right? And nep is Nepal. So I create a new file Nepal, and the new, this is new is keyboard, you have to write new, you don't have to change anything. And the here country, this country from here. And now echo, I'm going to print what? This nep here, and this arrow sign, and here have too many, right? Maybe nep, maybe I have more here. This next country, maybe IN. IN is India, right? India. I have more maybe here, this Africa, AF, maybe have Africa, semicolon. So here I have too many, right? Which one you want, then you have to write here. Maybe I want India, then I have to write IN here. Print now is India. See, maybe I want Africa, then I write here AF. Because this is going to create a one object from here, and going to call all from here. Anyone which want, you can print here. Maybe I want more here. If I want to print new here, and always, but you always have to write here nep. Maybe let me change here. Change what? Change COT, miss country. COUT. COUT. Country, right? So I'm going to write here COUT. And here, which one you want to print, just write here. Maybe I want to print one more here. This PK. Pakistan. If I write here PK, so that means I want to print PK, right? Why the color is changed? There is something wrong. So wrong is here. Semicolon, correct? Let me print here. Ah, no break, right? Because you see here Africa, and the first one is Africa, yeah, and second one is this one, Pakistan. So Africa is here and Pakistan is here, correct? Very easy, right? So this is how to create object, and how this is object, and this is not object, this is class and the function. So this is object and this is how we print. So you no need to worry about create object and what I learn, I teach you. You have to just learn integer, float, and string, and array. Only 4 and the build one function. Only 5. Then this one we will learn in framework. So you no need to worry. So see you in next class. I hope you guys understand very well. If there have any problem, just ask me on my Facebook. So see you.